Let's take one example on RLC parallel circuit. Given RLC parallel circuit excited by a DC current source, at t equal to 0, the switch K is opened. Find V of t. So this is the given circuit. This circuit is powered by or energized by or excited by a current source of magnitude 1 by 3 amps. We have switch here. Look at the direction of switch. It is about to open. It is said that at t equal to 0, the switch will open. We are supposed to calculate voltage V, which is here. This is the node V where R, L, C are connected in parallel with 1 by 3 current source. We are supposed to calculate V of t. Now we'll assume that at t equal to 0, the switch is opened. The analysis can be done using S domain circuit. It will be simple. I will try to represent the same circuit in S domain. To represent the circuit in S domain, we should replace the capacitors by 1 upon Cs and the inductors by Ls, and the resistor will be kept as it is. And if there exist any constants, those should be replaced by constant by S. So in this case it will be 1 by 3 S. I will draw the S domain circuit. Equivalent S domain circuit is shown below. So the magnitude of current source is 1 by 3. In S domain it will be represented as 1 by 3 S. So the switch is open. Here we have a resistor. In S domain resistor should be kept as it is. The value of resistor is 1 by 4 ohm. Here we have inductor. In S domain, inductor should be replaced by L into S. The inductor value is 1 by 4 into S. That is, it is nothing but S by 4. And we have capacitor here. The capacitor is replaced by 1 upon C into S. So here value of C is 1. So it will be 1 by S. So here we have V of S. So we have transformed time domain circuit into S domain circuit. Now we'll try to apply KCL at this node. Apply KCL to node V. So I can write it as, we'll assume that current through this branch is I1, this branch is I2, and this branch is I3. Therefore, I can write it as 1 upon 3S is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. That is, incoming current is equal to outgoing current. I can write it as 1 over 3S equal to I1 is nothing but V by S divided by 1 by 4. V by S divided by 1 by 4 plus I2 is nothing but V by S divided by S by 4. V by S divided by S by 4, and I3 is V by S divided by 1 by S. We will simplify this further. 1 over 3S is equal to, so I'll take this 4 on numerator, it will be 4 into V of S plus 4 V of S by S plus S V of S. I'll simplify this further. I can write it as 1 over 3s is equal to, I'll take V of s common here. I can write 4 plus 4 by s plus s. So I'll simplify this further as 1 upon 3s equal to V of s in bracket, I'll take s LCM here. We'll get it as 4s plus 4 plus s square. I simplify this further. So I'll take this s on right hand side and that s and this s will get cancelled. So I can write it as 1 over 3 is equal to V of s in bracket s square plus 4s plus 4. I'll continue here. Therefore, I can write it as V of s is equal to 1 upon s square plus 4s plus 4. Or I can write it as V of s is equal to 1 by 3 1 upon s plus 2 whole square. Now we supposed to convert this s domain into time domain. That is, by applying inverse Laplace transform, we can convert V of s into V of t. Apply inverse Laplace transform. That is, we know that Laplace transform of t e raised to minus st, it gives 1 upon s plus a whole square. It means that is Laplace transform of t e raised to minus at is 1 upon s plus a whole square. It means inverse Laplace transform of 1 upon s plus a whole square is equal to t e raised to minus at. Here a value is 2. So this equation is similar to this equation. That is 1 upon s plus 2, where 2 is nothing but a. Therefore, Laplace transform of this one is 1 by 3 is constant, which should be kept as it is, 1 by 3 t e raised to minus 2 t. Therefore, we can write it as Laplace transform of V of s is V of t is equal to 1 by 3 is constant. Laplace transform of inverse Laplace transform of this term is t e raised to minus 2t. So this is the required V of t for the given problem. Thank you for watching.